Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Kristen and today I'm going to show you how to paint marigolds in watercolor. Marigolds are super fun. They're a wildflower variety and they're pretty simple to paint, so let's get started. The first thing you're going to do is choose your color of marigold. This one is going to be a yellow and I'm painting these really short yellow petals right in the center, and then I'm doing these kind of wavy petals just all along the end. And I'm doing kind of a half heart shape where you're seeing the two bumps at the top, but no point at the end. Marigolds are a full flower. They're kind of fluffy looking. They've got lots of different layers with petals. So we're going to continue to make this bumpy shape around and around the marigold. Make sure to maintain the white space so you can see the distinction between the layers. And then the flower itself, when you're looking at it from an angle, is going to be kind of an oval shape. Using a darker pigment of red to add that same color effect to the bottom of these petals. And what adding this color does to your marigolds is it not only adds, you know, depth and dimension and interest because there's another color, it also gives the illusion that the petals are farther down in the flower where they're darker. So it gives the illusion of shadowing. So this marigold that I'm painting here and two of the other yellow ones across the page don't have the middle showing. And so the greenery for the base of these flowers is going to be a little bit different. It's going to be kind of similar to carnations, but not quite as full and bulbous. Curving the stems of your flowers always helps them look a little bit more natural and organic. And then I'm just bringing that greenery up to the rest of the marigolds. And then in just a little bit here, I'm going to create the leaves. And because marigolds are wildflowers, you can really have fun and play around with the leaves being, you know, more crazy and wild. Marigold leaves are a little bit pokier, and so you can have fun with the edges and how everything looks. Also, marigold leaves love to be up and around the flower, and so you can paint them right up next to your flowers and the buds. So now I'm adding in the final details. And you know I like to add in darker contrast of greenery to the leaves to make them pop. Also adding the little bits of pollen at the end of the stamens just to these open flowers. So as I'm finishing up the piece, I noticed I felt like the upper left needed some greenery, and it felt like the perfect spot to add a little bud. And because the base of the flowers have that bulbous greenery bit, that's what the bud looks like. So less flower and more of that bulbous green type of bud. And really at this point in the painting, when I'm adding those final details and I'm feeling out the balance of the composition, I'm just really trying to get a feel for what needs to be added. And I felt like we still needed more greenery to balance out both of the sides, especially because when I'm looking at the reference pictures for wildflowers, the greenery is out of control. They have so many leaves. And I remember that when we were growing them at our house. And so I just took the opportunity to add a few more leaves, and I think it really helped make it look
wild and also balanced.
And now that we have practiced our marigolds, I am adding mine to my watercolor flower guide, and I love the yellow-orange color that this adds to our guide because we need a little bit more yellow. Thank you so much for being here today while we painted marigolds together. Today was day 20 of our 30 days of watercolor flowers, and I will see you tomorrow for day 21. Bye.